Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse racket review of the Vocal V-Cell 10 320. The heaviest Vocal 10 in the family has been updated with V-Cell, a light and strong cellulose material added to the layup for improved feel and responsiveness, while the butt cap and V-Sensor handle has been reinforced with a material called Reva for greater shock absorption. At nearly 12 ounces strong, this 98-square-inch racket is 6 points head light with a 323 swing weight, a flex rating of 66, and a string pattern of 16 by 19. All this means is the racket should offer good stability and allow players to ramp up the speed with an optimal blend of controlled power.
Really enjoyed this playtest and the racket of Vocal's new V-Cell 10320. You know, things are kind of tending to lean in a more modern direction. There is a little smidge of modernness to this frame, but I like it that it kind of harkens back to some of my favorite Vocal frames. The 9 and the 10s from both the DNX and the PowerBridge days, really liked them. So if you're thinking this frame is going to be exactly like that, the cross section is a little thicker. You'll get a little bit more of an energy return, but it's still a touchy-feely frame. So 320 grams of plow through versus like a 7-point headlight strung balance and a sub-320 swing weight. I thought it worked great. All this came together. I had really no problem finding my spots in the court. You guys know my game. It's counter-punching, changing direction of the ball. And with this one, I was actually able to hit through the court and put a little bit more pace and spin on my shot, so I just wasn't trying to tax the other player. My favorite shot, believe it or not, to hit with this racket was probably my return. Something about the balance versus the swing weight allowed me to get in and take a little bit more time for a topspin cut at the ball on my service return. But overall, if you're looking for a racket, like, I really like the RF. It's a little too heavy for me. If I was going to go with a ProStaff 97, I might modify it. However, this 320 kind of sits right in between and bridges the gap. So it gives me pretty much what I need in terms of weight, balance, everything to kind of complement my game.
Overall, this racket performed well. I enjoyed the pairing of a 319 swing weight with a 320 gram frame. From the baseline, I was able to generate pretty heavy topspin off both wings, and with that 319 swing weight, it was really nice to generate nice racket head speed throughout the play test. During point play, I was able to settle in and really hit consistent and confident strokes from the baseline. Though, if I were to knock the racket at all, I would have wanted a little more pinpoint accuracy during a hitting session. I felt like I had to open up my target zone a little bit more than normal with this frame. You know, when I had an opponent out of position, wanted to put the ball away, felt like I couldn't quite pull the trigger with full confidence. That said, up at net, it gave me exactly what I wanted with a nice, firm punch to my volleys. I'm not necessarily a touch player, so, you know, the ability with a stiffer frame to really put away a volley with power was really nice in doubles play. So overall, if you're a player looking for a racket with, you know, excellent access to racket head speed with that lower swing weight, but still enough mass to really drive the ball in the court, I'd absolutely recommend giving this one a look.
The first thing that jumped out to me when using this racket was solid, how solid it felt on every shot, especially up at net. Really felt like this racket felt very stable, very crisp and precise feeling. It felt like the ball got in and out pretty quickly. Wasn't the kind of sense of dwell time and pocketing of Vocals of the past, but instead it's been replaced by a bit more of a modern, crisper response and just a very direct feel. So I could just line up the string bed where I wanted my volleys to go, watch the ball zip away there. Really like that punch and stab I got on the volleys. Also on returns, I thought it was a very direct feeling racket. I could take a good rip of the ball, keep my shots nicely on target. Really like this one strung up with some Cyclone in it, as it gave the string bed some nice grip and bite, and I was able to access the power and plow through I was getting from the mass of this racket and get the spin I needed to get the ball dipping nicely inside the lines. Really fun racket to get out and just rally with. It's a very consistent feeling racket, and good blend of power and control, not like tons of either, and then enough directional control for me to place the ball where I wanted to. So not a racket I'm gonna be like serving bombs with, but definitely good pace on my serves, good spin on my serve, getting some nice action on my slice serve out wide. And so really a racket that I get out of it what I put in, and I can trust in those tight situations when I'm playing points.
I'm always interested to see what Vocal's new technology feels like on the court, and this was a fun play test. I felt like this racket offered me more control than power, but at times I felt like it was having a little bit of an identity crisis where I really wanted to step up my power and I just was lacking a tiny bit. but I also found it to swing very fast for a racket of its weight. But on the other hand, I also was looking for a little more plow through from a 320-gram racket. I am super picky when it comes to stability, so if I was hitting against someone that was hitting big balls back at me and they were close to the baseline, I did struggle a tiny bit with stability. However, at net, I'd had no issues. The racket played really firm for me. And on serve was probably my favorite spot to hit this racket. I felt pretty dialed in with my shot selection, whether I was going for big first serves or trying to add more spin or more kick to my shots. I do want to mention it did feel a bit firm for me. I really did enjoy Volkl Cyclone, but I had to bump the tension down from what I normally gravitate towards. So under 55 pounds was just fine for me on this playtest, and that seemed to unlock the sweet spot a little bit better for my game. But all in all, a great playtest, and it's great to see this line of rackets evolve. We playtested this racket with several different string setups, but the playtesters loved it with Volkl Cyclone 16 at 53 pounds. To learn more about this racket and many others, please visit our websites at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.